Hey guys, what's up? Dan here with a new video. For the past few days, I've been trying to level up my character, so as you can see, I am very close to being done. Yeah, level 99%. Now, this was quite a long journey. I have learned quite a lot, but I thought that it would be a good idea to record the final map, yeah? So, this is one of the three strategies that I have been running for the past few days, which is gonna be Beyond, yeah? Now, in case you don't know, Beyond is giving you quite a lot of experience. These maps right here are giving you around 1.1-1.2% experience at level 99 per map, which is quite amazing, yeah? So for the Scarab configuration, we're going with Abysses, Sulfite for the movement speed tech, we have the Harbinger, and we have the Blight, yeah? So this would be the strategy. Now, there's also gonna be two other simpler strategies that I'm about to show you after we're done with this first one. But yeah, let's run this final map and see how it goes. Okay guys, and at the start of the map, you summon your spiders. That is if you're playing the Arakali Svenko cultist. And then we're gonna go inside the map. I'm gonna pop my sentinel and engage with a lot of care. Essences are a no-no. Never take essences, yeah? Okay, now in a moment here, there's gonna be a lot of Beyond monsters that are gonna spawn and probably try to clap me. So I need to be really careful. Okay, so... yeah, so this is how your maps are gonna look like. Now we're gonna need to be extra careful until we kill the monsters with the sentinels, yeah? And so the monsters that have been buffed by sentinels are quite nasty. As you can see, we have the magma barriers that are chasing me. Oh my god. Yeah, guys. Okay. You have to be careful with the Bamest, yeah? This archer guy right here. If you stay in corpses, he's gonna detonate the corpses and you're gonna die. Oh god. This is one of the worst things that I could have done for level 100. Yeah, so I had to switch this up a little bit. So I didn't run that many maps. Mostly because my PC can't handle it, yeah. But as you can see, they are quite nasty, yeah. Both on the PC and on your, you know, safety and peace of mind, I should say, yeah. So these are quite nasty maps. Okay, so let's try to kill these guys here. Now, you'll see me stutter-stepping. The reason that I'm stutter-stepping is because I don't have bleeding immunity. And if I walk too fast while I have a bleed, I'm gonna die. Yeah, so I need to be careful with bleeds. Okay, so we should be getting very close to level 100 here. Okay. For... yes, finally, guys, we're done. Oh my god. Such a long journey. Let's take a quick look at the Atlas skill tree. As you can see, we have a lot of monsters inside our maps. We have the Shrines, we have the Harbingers, we have the Abysses, we have the Blights, and we have the Beyonds, yeah, which are giving us quite a lot of extra experience per maps. Now, since I'm really not that confident with running Beyond, and this was my first time that I ran it for leveling up, I decided to not take Torn Veil. Now, if you're experienced and your build is really powerful, you could take this node right here, and you could also take the Sextant, yeah, which gives you extra Beyond on the map. And if you're really confident, you could also spec into these nodes right here, so that you have more Beyond per map, yeah. This is gonna make your leveling up quite nicer. I'm guessing around 1.4-1.5% experience per map at level 99, which is quite a lot, to be honest. But please keep in mind, the maps are gonna be really hard. As for my second Atlas skill tree, I just took out the points from Beyond and I put them into Shaper Elder and the Conqueror maps. For this farm, I was going in increments of 5%, yeah, so one small bar that you see here is a 5% experience. With the first strategy, you're gonna need 5 maps for a 5%, and with the second strategy, you're gonna need around 8 maps to get 5% experience. The Scarab configuration was Rusted Blight for really nice experience and a little bit of money per map. We were going with the Polished Abyss. Try to go with Polished since these give 50% increased monsters. These are quite nice if you're trying to level up. The third Scarab was a Rusted Harbinger Scarab, and the fourth Scarab was a Rusted Sulfite Scarab for the Nico packed with energy nodes, yeah? So there was also another thing that I was trying to get with this Atlas skill tree, which would be defenses, yeah? So we went with the packed with energy nodes, which is gonna be 3% maximum resistance from the Rusted Sulfite Scarab. and also the shrines are giving you quite nice defensive bonuses. This node right here, which is called the Syncretism, is giving you an additional shrine effect, yeah? So you click one shrine and you get two shrine effects, which are gonna last around 1.5 minutes, yeah? So this is gonna feel quite nice during mapping. So how many maps did I run with the first strategy? I ran in total 60 maps, I died 2 times to stun, and at that point I decided to spec into Soul of the Brine King, yeah? So this is quite nice if you don't have a stun immunity. Now the thing with the bleeding immunity, I couldn't really fix it, I think it's this right here, yeah? Yeah, Soul of Rala Kesh. As you can see, moving while bleeding doesn't cause you to take extra damage, because I was already taking Soul of Aberrat for the Burning Ground immunity, yeah? So sadly, I couldn't figure out the immunity to bleeding. I would have had to buy another ring, you know, take a look at the passive skill tree, you know, change it a little bit. I just wanted to get it done. So I died once to bleeding and 2 times to stuns. Once I specced into Soul of the Brine King, I stopped dying to stuns. So in total, I ran 60 maps with Beyond and I managed to only get 30% experience. Afterwards, I removed Beyond from the map device and I went with the second strategy, which is pretty much the same as the first one without running Beyond. It was taking me 8 maps to get 5% experience and I managed to get to level 99 and 73%. Yeah, so the strategy was pretty simple. I would go inside the map, pop the sentinel at the start of the map, kill the monsters, and then I would continue running the map. And now the thing is, on a level 99 and a 73%, after using this sentinel right here, a Minotaur simply one-shotted me, guys. Yeah, so this has never happened in 99 levels and a 73% experience, no matter what sentinel I used. A Minotaur has never one-shot me. However, this time it was a one-shot. Like, there was no time to react. I really don't know what happened. Yeah, anyway, so to me it kind of felt like the game was memeing, yeah? So I was like, okay, POV, you want a meme? Then two of us can play this game. And welcome to the third and the final strategy, which is gonna be In and Out Blight. Yeah, so I was pretty annoyed, I'm not gonna lie. You know, dying again, back to 63% experience. Yeah, it really wasn't fun. So I wanted to do something that's gonna be decently safe, which was In and Out Blights. I would go inside the map, clear the monsters until I find the Blight encounter, get my experience from the Blight encounter, and then go out. Once every 28 maps or so, I would go and collect the Incandescent Invitation, yeah? So for the third strategy, you're gonna need around 15 maps, yeah? I decided to go with beach maps since these have quite nice layouts. I was rolling them properly, not the way you see these right here. And I was using Rusted Blight Scarab and Rusted Sulfite Scarab, yeah? So the only thing I wanted in these maps was increased movement speed and maximum resistances and the experience from the Blight encounters, yeah? So you're gonna need 5 maps for 5% experience, you're gonna need 8 maps for 5% experience without the Beyonds, and you're gonna need around 15 maps for 5% experience if you're only gonna go for the Blight encounters and a few monsters along the way until you manage to get to them, yeah? The Atlas skill tree with the third strategy wasn't changed, yeah, because I was a little bit annoyed after dying again. You could unspec some of these nodes and you could go into the chance for map drop duplication if you want a little bit of extra currency. But yeah, I made quite decent money with this strategy as well. I think around 4.5-5x per hour, yeah? So let me show you some of the loot. I have already emptied around 2 quad tabs, yeah? So as you can see, we have a lot of loot, guys, yeah? 4 quad tabs, and I think I emptied another 2. Now, if you're gonna go for level 100, you have to adjust your playstyle a little bit. The most important thing that I have discovered was this PoE rejects tool that you can see right here. You basically come to this website, it will be linked in the description of this video, and you check the mods that you don't want to see in any of these maps. I would recommend a quantity of at least 70%, and then you copy this rejects right here, and you paste it here inside the game. As you're starting to roll the maps, you're gonna see them highlight. Whichever map gets highlighted means that it doesn't contain those mods from that website, so they are safe to run. Yeah, so we're gonna have to reroll these a few times until we manage to get the ones that are not containing any mods that would break our build, yeah? So for example, we got another 2 here. Now, there are some limitations with the PoE rejects tool, mostly because the game, yeah, in this bar right here, you can only input 50 characters. So how would you go about that if you have some extra mods that are breaking your build? You're gonna come on this page, copy it inside another tab, and then you're gonna edit this second page right here so that you get an extra reject. So let's say that these mods right here are really bothering you. Yeah, so we have a limitation of 50 characters, so let's remove some of these because the maps are already rolled and they don't contain these mods. Yeah, so we're gonna copy the second rejects as well, and you're gonna copy this inside the game, and you're gonna notice that out of the four maps that we initially rolled, we are only left with two, yeah, because these right here could be breaking your build. So monsters deal 90% extra physical as fire, you know, maybe it's a little bit too dangerous for you, so you should probably reroll that. So you would just alternate between one or two rejects, or, you know, just go with one rejects and then individually check all of the maps to see if there are some mods that are really nasty for your build. Now, in terms of your character, you're gonna need a lot of defenses and a lot of immunities. I died two times to stunts, so I changed my Pantheon to Brine King. Shock immunity is a must, I have a Tempest Shield, and you really need to play differently. Overcapped resistances are also necessary. 75% these days, if you're trying to go for level 100 with the Arch Nemesis mods, I would say is not enough. It's definitely enough for, you know, casual, regular play, but if you wanna level up and die as little as possible, you're gonna need overcapped resistances, I would say at least 80%. Besides that, you have two routes, which would be full block and spell block with recover on block or spell suppression. In terms of running the maps, efficiency is not the way to go here. You need to take it a little bit slower and be extra careful, since 10% at level 99 is quite a lot of time. There are 4 extremely rippy things in a PoE right now that you should skip if you want to level up. Essences have killed me once, so I remove them from this grind. Metamorphs, although fun, are way too risky. Stromboxes are a big no because the Ice Nova Strombox simply does too much damage. As for the Sentinels, I would say the red one is okay, as long as you engage with the utmost care and don't tank any hits from empowered monsters. And one more thing I like to mention is that the beach map boss sometimes does a lot of damage, so try to engage from a really big distance, don't get close to him. Okay guys, solo level 100, how does it feel? Well, not gonna lie, it feels quite nice, but please keep in mind, the time investment is really big. Besides the time, you also need to perform. These final 1-200 maps won't feel like your average maps. I actually ended up being a little bit paranoid during this final level because the scenarios that were killing me were a little bit ridiculous. Up until this point, I didn't really notice them, so you're gonna need to perform, and this is quite a big grind. There are a lot of fun things in PoE that you can do right now, but sadly, this is not one of them. Way too many punishing ground effects, detonates, overtuned Arch Nemesis monsters, lags, freezes, slows, chills, grasping vines, and so many more. The only reason I went for this was because I got baited by this tanky character that somehow ended up at level 98 and 63% without me caring about dying. So yeah, it feels good, but I wouldn't really recommend it. Use these farming strategies until level 96, 97 and stop there. If you really want something to do that's gonna take a bit of time but also feel quite fun, go for a headhunter or a mage blood and try out a lot of farming strategies. You're gonna have a blast, and once you put that belt on, oh man, your build is gonna feel insane. Now here, you get an extra point, which for me is a 6% maximum life. I did all that for a 6% maximum life. Yeah guys, don't do this. Thank you for watching, good luck as always, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.